What's up, SBL? Today, I thought it'd be wicked to shine the light on some of the greatest bass women in rock. Some of my favourites, but obviously I'm sure that I'll have missed some people out as well. So as we're going through this, in the comments below, let me know who you would have loved to see featured in this video, and I'll make sure that I get them in the next one. So with that said, let's do it. So let's jump in with who I believe is the godmother of rock bass. Obviously, Suzie Quatro. Playing one of those old Gibsons, they sound wicked. This is 1973. Now, one thing about Suzie is that she's got like a great groove, and it's maybe because of her influences. She came from Detroit and was listening to James Jameson back in the day. She's just got it going on. Like, check this out. Hit that great fundamental there.
Very basic bass. I'm a Detroit girl, born and raised. My hero, and who I really tuned into, was Jameson from Motown.
Now next up we've got the great Tina Weymouth from obviously Talking Heads and Tom Tom Club. Check this out, you'll probably know the bass line. What is it? And we can actually see Tina play right here on her old P bass that definitely looks like it's seen a little action. Okay, so next up we've got Kim Deal with the Pixies. And if you've not listened to the Pixies, you don't know anything about them. This is really where Nirvana came from. It was really the Pixies. And this I know, his teeth is white. And I love the way that she plays as well with the pick close to the neck. Walk her every day into it just gives the tone just a really distinct kind of character, right? Okay, so next up is the one and only Gail Ann Dorsey. What else to say? Obviously, she's played with Tears for Fears, she played with Bowie, she played with plays with Lenny Kravitz and a bunch of others. Check it out. Bass sounds mint. Oh. So good. Listen to her voice right now. She's got such a great voice as well. Okay, so next up with White Zombie, obviously Sean Yseult. If you haven't heard this track, Black Sunshine, just check out, it'd be worth checking out the original as well, just check out the bass tone on the beginning of it. It's killing. That picks at an angle to get that scrapey sound. She's not picking flat, she's picking at an angle, gives it that real particular tone. Okay, so next up, and I'm not sure whether I'm pronouncing this right because I'm just terrible with pronunciation, but it's Melissa Auf Der Maur. She's played with a bunch of great bands, Hole being one of them, but she also played with my favourite rock band of all time,
Smashing Pumpkins. And just check out the bass tone. It's phenomenal. I love it. And the bass tone on that. Now, I've actually got a couple more. I should only have one more. I've got a couple more because, hey, it's you know, Scott's bass lessons. Yeah, I can really do what I want with this channel. But I've got one more, so don't go anywhere. But next up is Paz Lenchantin, and this is with Perfect Circle, fantastic band, Josh Fries on drums. What a phenomenal drummer. And she's got a similar vibe going on. She's got the P bass, she's got a pick, you know, similar vibe to Melissa. Different tone, but still absolutely killing. Just check it out. You can hear how sort of like it's got so much bottom end on the tone. And finally, and no, she's not just a rock bass player. Can you guess who it is? Maybe you can't. I'm going to tell you in 1 second. A lot of her solo stuff is so rock influenced that I have to have her on the list. I've got to have her on the list. And she's just such a phenomenal bass player as well. Just from any direction that you look, she's just a really, really fantastic bass player. And let me know in the comments as well, which of the genres do you want us to cover? But anyway, check this out. It's really great. Tal Wilkenfeld. Don't rescue me, I've got nowhere better I want to be. Great band as well. I want to be held, but not be holy. Stand in my ground with one eye open. Guys, thanks so much for taking the time to watch this video. Hopefully you enjoyed some of like learning about some of the players. I absolutely love putting this list together for you and learned a ton about women bass players that have done so many great tunes that I've loved in the past and I didn't even know who was playing bass on them. Anyway, if you want more videos like this, obviously make sure that you subscribe to the channel and have your notifications switched on. And if you haven't been over to Scott's Bass Lessons yet, which is what I and the team do, we run the biggest online bass school for bass players just like you, so you can take your bass playing to the next level. We've got a phenomenal faculty and you can do it all from the comfort of your own home. So go to scottsbasslessons.com and grab your 14-day free trial as well, just to check it out. Now with that said, take it easy and I'll see you in the shed.